Good afternoon, my Dhamma brothers and Dhamma sisters. Today is 29th October 2030. Afternoon lecture about on Nirvana. So Bahiya Sutta. Special note, Bahiya Sutta. According to Bahiya Sutta, I will explain about Nirvana. What the Buddha explained Nirvana. Bahiya Sutta. Bahiya is the name of monks. The name of monks, a monk. The Buddha taught to Bahiya how to practice vipassana, to attain nirvana, how to practice. So the Buddha said, Tasma diha te bahiya eva sakhitara. Tasma diha, tasma iha. In this teaching, Tasma means therefore in this teaching, Ubhahiya. You must follow this practice. You must practice in this way. Eva Sakhitapa. You must follow this practice in this way. The Buddha gave guidelines. That is vipassana practice. Deite deita matam bhavesati. Sute sutta matam bhavesati. Mute mutta matam bhavesati. Vinyate vinyata matam bhavesati. Deita means seeing. On seeing. Sutta means hearing. Mudda means sensing. Vinyata means cognizing. That is the meaning. Eye, ear, nose, tongue. Eye, ear, nose, tongue, body. It's my. We have six senses, sense organs, eye, ear, nose, tongue, body, and mind. The object coming to contact these six senses, sense organs. To meditate upon it, to practice regarding to thus the Buddha's taught Bahiya in this way. This practice is very popular. Deite deita matam. Deite deita matam practice is very popular. So first we must know in this way. Deite means in the scene, what we see. That is the meaning, when we see visual object. When we see visual object, deite. There will be merely the scene. If we say in brief, in the sea, there will be merely the scene. That is the meaning. When we see visual object, we must try to stop just seeing. just see, no more thinking about it with the craving and the hatred, delusion. Seeing just a seeing. That is its meaning. What you see, the visual object of what you see, you should not think with the lobha, dosa, moha. Just seeing is just a seeing. No more think about it is beautiful, it is ugly, it is lovable, it is desirable, not desirable. Don't think like that. That is the meaning. Just a seeing, seeing, just a seeing. Don't let craving arise to that object. Deity, deita, matam, bhavesati. Yeah, situations that the Buddha has explained. But we must follow in this way. Seeing must be merely seeing. No more thinking about as a desirable or undesirable, lovable, unlovable. Don't think in this way. If you think about it, that seeing, it is desirable. Craving will attach. Craving will arise to it. When you think about it, it is undesirable. The hatred arises to the object. Especially, the Buddha wished to say, not to let craving or hatred or delusion regarding to the object. Seeing must be stopped, just seeing. Don't consider continuously. That is the meaning. Therefore, meditation masters, according to Mahasatipatthana Sutta, Kachando wa kachamiti pachanati. So they say, if one going, must note that. See and seeing, must note just see. Not to consider beyond that. It is not so easy to control, because our mind is so quick. After seeing, just seeing, they consider as a desirable or undesirable. Quickly think about such a things. Then craving and hatred come into being. Therefore, in meditation practice, it's necessary. Adapi, adapa, great effort. Without a great effort, we cannot succeed. Adapi, sambajano. We must have comprehension. We must have knowledge. Without knowledge, cannot succeed. Satima. We must have mindfulness, otherwise we cannot succeed. Effort, knowledge, sati. Samavayama, right effort. Samasati, right mindfulness. Samadhi, right understanding. These three things are very, very important for practice meditation, for meditation practice. Without these, we cannot succeed. That is the meaning. Deity, deita, matam, bhavesati. And seeing It must be only seeing. Just seeing. In just seeing, just see, if we not consider the object, if we not consider that object, desirable or undesirable, there will be no craving or no hatred. If we consider desirable, undesirable, craving and hatred will be. We must control not to let craving rise towards the object. Every day we open our eye and we see spiritual object. On seeing, we consider. When we consider as a desirable, craving for it rises. When we consider it is undesirable, hatred rises. If we does not know the natures of the object, delusion rises. So, in the case of seeing, there are a lot of mental defilements coming to being, following, coming to being. The Buddha wants to say, don't let mental defilement rise within you towards the object. On seeing. Is it possible or not? Is it possible? Because there must be, there need very strong mindfulness. Mindfulness is very important. There need great effort, samavayamas, you see, not to let any evil to arise, not to let any evil arise. Must try to do so. Deite deita madam bhavesati. How to follow this practice regarding to seeing? The Buddha want to say, deita matta, just see, don't let craving or hatred arise towards the object. Don't let the delusion arise toward the object. So many people are on seeing, there are many kinds of defilements arises towards the object. Therefore the Buddha advised or taught Bahiya, you must follow this practice and seeing, you must be just seeing. No more consider about the object, desirable, undesirable. If you consider desirable, undesirable, mental defilements will arise. Mental defilements come into being. In the same way, on hearing, Sutta Matam Bhavesati. Sutta means in hearing. Hearing sound. The most people's hearing sound or listening to sound, especially listening to music. Some people are using earphone or year 8. They are shaking the whole bodies, following the music. What has happened? Listening to sound. The music instruments beating, he also shaking accordingly. The whole body is shaking, moving. Because he consider that is a desirable, sweet sound, nice sound. He think, therefore he following the sound, shaking the whole bodies, enjoying. When I visit Germany, on the train I saw a gentleman using earphone, he listened to sound. He never take care of the people who close to him. He's shaking, following the sound. So the Buddha advised us, don't follow the sound, considering that is a sweet sound. That is desirable. If you think there is a desirable, nice sound, sweet sound, craving for it will arise. Therefore, sute sute matter. Hearing, just hearing. I'm hearing sound, just a sound. If you consider music, there are various sounds come into being. If you separate it one by one, useless, you see. Many sounds appeared at that time. If you consider one by one, not together, it's useless, you see. Not sweet. Now it is jumping, 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 boom, 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 so many, you see. People are following and they consider that it's a very nice sound. So, sutta, sutta, madam, bhavaisati. You must follow this practice. Whenever you hear the sound, hear sound. You must be only mere sound. Don't consider more about the sound, desirable or undesirable, or sweet or not sweet. If you consider that is a desirable sound, craving for it will come into being. If you consider this sound is so noise, the hatred is coming to being. I dislike this so nice, noisy sounds. I hate, so hatred is coming to being. If you cannot know the natures of sound, delusions coming to being. So, lobha, dosa, moha, craving, hatred, delusions come into being on hearing sound. The Buddha taught us not to let craving, hatred, delusion towards the sound arise. Craving, hatred, delusion arise towards the sound. That is the advice. Sute sutta matta bhavesati. When we hear, when we are hearing sound, it must be just hearing. Don't consider that it's sweet or not sweet, desirable or not desirable. Just hear. With mindfulness, with right understanding, with the knowledge, with a great effort. Every day we experience this very object and sound. Then mutti, mutta, mattam, bhavisati. Mutta, these terms are used for smelling, tasting, touching. These three. Smelling with the nose, tasting with the tongue, touching with the body. That is called here mutta. Because of this are directly be in touch sense organs. Sense organs. The smells touched the nose. Taste also touched the tongue. Tangible object also touched the body. Therefore, it is called mutta. These objects are in touch. Here, translators are used mutti. When we are sensed, that is the meaning. When we are smelling, tasting, touching, when we smell, when we are getting smell, we must be just a smell. Don't consider good and bad. If we are tasting with our tongue, we must merely taste. Don't consider it's a desirable taste or undesirable taste. If you consider, mental development is coming to be. That is the meaning. Taste is just taste. If a salty taste is a salty taste, sour, sour taste, just sweet, sweet taste, just a taste. Don't consider good, bad. That is the meaning in meditation practice. Not to let. Actually, the Buddha wants to say, on smelling, don't let mental defilements arise within you. On tasting, don't let mental defilements towards the object. When you touch that tangible object, don't let mental defilements arise towards the tangible object. Just merely the object, you must practice. That is a goal, mutti, mutta, matta, bhavisati. Vinyati, vinyata, matta means this is mind, referring to mind, six sense organs. When we cognize the object, sometimes we are closing the eye, not listening sound, not get a smell, not a taste, not a touch. Just think about. Just think. What we experienced yesterday, what we experienced just before, we think about that, good or bad, desirable or undesirable. Considering about such an object, craving or hatred coming to be towards the object. Therefore, vinyati vinyanapada. Some people are just thinking something what has happened. Hatred coming to be. No? Hatred coming to be. Thinking about something which is past. Craving for it coming to be. The Buddha wants to say, don't let any kind of mental defilements arise towards such an object. So, Daiti Dita Madam Bhavisati, this one to say, regarding to visual object, don't let mental defilements arise toward that object. Sutta Sutta Madam Bhavisati, sound we heard, don't let mental defilement arise towards that object. Mute muta matam bhavisati. On smelling, tasting, touching, don't let mental defilements arise towards such an object. Thinking about something, on thinking about something, don't let mental defilements arise towards what we thought. That is sati sampajanya, sati sampajanya, mindfulness and comprehension. Like in Mahasatipatthana Sutta, Mahasatipatthana Sutta. You must have mindfulness towards the object. You must have comprehension or right understanding towards the object. If you control your mind with a great effort, mindfulness and knowledge, within you, mental defilements are not a chance to arise. So the Buddha taught Bahiya, Ewanyi de bahiya sekitava. You must follow this practice. This is a vipassana practice. Okay, vipassana practice. According to Mahasatipatthana Sutta, kaya kaya nupasi viharati adabi sambhajano satima viniya logi abeja domanasa. The same things, you see. The same things. One dwells contemplating the body in the body with the great effort, mindfulness, comprehension, removing covetousness and grief. The same things, you see. Ditti ditta matam bhavisati. Towards the object. Sutti sutta matam bhavisati. Mutti mutta matam bhavisati. Vinyati vinyata matam bhavisati. Yes, these are the same things as Satipatthana object. According to following Satipatthana method, we can do data matter. In seeing, just a seeing. Not another practice. Buddha said, there is only one way. Not two ways, not other ways. Only the way, only way. This path is only way. Two, only way. to purify beings, to overcome worry and lamentation, to cease physical pain and mental pain, to find out the way to Nirvana, Nyayasa Adhikamaya, to attain Nirvana, Nirvana Satchikriyaya. That is the only way. This is not a new way. Deity, Deita, Matam, Bhoesati, Sute, Sutta, Matam, Bhoesati, Mute, Mutta, Matam, Bhoesati, Vinyade. That is a Satipatthana method. The same. That is not another way from Majjhima Patipatthana. This is Majjhima Patipatthana. Only Eightfold Noble Path. According to Eightfold Noble Path. Therefore, the Buddha says, Ika yano ayam bhikkhu mekho. This way is only way, single way, or only single direction, only referring to Nirvana. If you walk on this way, you will attain Nirvana. That is the meaning. Deity, Deity, Madam practice is not other practice, just meditations, Satipatthana meditations, just Vipassana meditations, just Majjhima Patipatthana, to follow Majjhima Patipatthana. So, the Buddha's taught by here. Then we explain the benefit, advantage of the, this practice. Yadode bahiya dete deta madam bhoisati. If you can do that, if you can practice such a way, on seeing, just me, on seeing, and seeing will be merely seeing. Sute, Sutta, Matam, Bhoesati. On hearing, just hearing. Mute, Mutta, Matam. And sensed, just sensed. On smelling, just smelling. On tasting, just tasting. On touching, just touching. On cognizant, just cognizant. Vinyade vinyada matta bhavisati. When you succeed in such a practice, what is the benefit? What is the advantage? Tatotom bahiya natena. Tatotom bahiya natena. Natena is referring to you will be not with the mental defilement. Want to say, Natina. Because with the object, our mind arises with the object. On that object, craving, towards that object, craving arises, hatred arises, delusion arises. Therefore, not dena. With such an object, within you, craving never arises, hatred never arises, delusion never arises. Towards such an object, mental defilements never arises. The Buddha wants to say, Tadotam bahiya natina. Natina means not with the object, raga dosa moha arises. raga dosa moha arises. That's not a concern with the object. Most people are concerned with the object. Other problems, any problems arises with the object. You see, on hearing, on seeing, on smelling, on tasting, on touching, the problems arises to us. Mental defilements also arises to us that. If we can control, if we can follow it this way, this practice, there will be no problem with this object. This will be no problem. What is the problem? Problem is here craving, hatred, delusion. Mental defilements are problems with the object. No harm at all. Yatotum bahiya nadena, tatotum bahiya nadata. If you have no mental defilements with that object, with that object, you will not remain that object. Most people are, you see, on seeing beautiful object, they remain with the craving for it. Thinking about that, the whole night, the whole night, considering, oh, so nice, so nice, I want. If a hatred appeared, so bad, consider about it. That is remaining on that object. On seeing, the people's mind remaining the object. With the what? With the craving, with the hatred, with the delusion. The Buddha said, you cannot remain on that. Just seeing, finish seeing, fading away. No more. No more consider about that. On seeing, just seeing, finish. On hearing, just hearing. No more consider about that. Never keep in the mind. Otherwise, you see, yesterday breakfast is very good. Lunch is very tasty. 2 days are not good. So considering, you see, the object, what we experience, we consider about that. Recalling it, recalling, comparing. That is the remaining the object. Therefore, yadodom bahiya natena, tadodom bahiya natata. Never remain on that with the mental defilement, with the defilement. Yadodom bahiya natata. If you not remain on that object, the dodon bahiya. So not on, that is the Buddha says explained. Natena means you have a never attachment, mental defilements. That is appearance of Mecca. Appearance of Mecca. Through vipassana meditation, they are appeared Mecca. Vipassana's benefit is Mecca. We must practice only vipassana. We need not practice Mecca. Vipassana is called Pubhabhaga Mecca. We must practice Pubhabhaga Mecca. Just the Mecca Chaita or Mecca Jnana. The path is just attainment. It is beneficial vipassana, advantage of vipassana. Without a vipassana, we cannot attain the mecca. Without a mecca, we cannot attain the phala. Without a mecca phala, we cannot see nirvana. We cannot experience nirvana. So, the Buddha say, if you wish to attain mecca, you must remove mental defilements, mental defilement from the object. What we attached is object. On seeing, we attached visible object. On hearing, we attached to the sound. On smelling, we attach to the smell. Like that, you see. Mental defilements towards the object. Through vipassana knowledge, if the craving never appeared towards the object, it is free from mental defilements. When free from mental defilements, yadodam bahiya natata. You are not attached to the object. You are not a remain on the object with the craving, with the hatred. When hatred appears to us as the object, we never forgot. Most people think they always remember who they love. That is not only beloved one. The hatred enemy also we always think about. We are always consider whom we hate also. That is called patika sanyojana. Patika sanyojana. Hatred also, you see, cannot remove easily. That is also sanyojana. Factors. Not only love is sanyojana, hatred is also sanyojana. Cannot remove easily from that object. So, if you can remove mental defilements from the object, the dotum bahiya, nivita, because of he attained in mecca phala, removed all mental defilements, therefore, the Buddha wants to say nirvana here, the dotum bahiya, nivita na hura, na ubhya mantrena. Like before, you see. Oh. Bahiya, if you are not remained with the mental defilement on that object, you will be neither here nor beyond, nor others, nor there, neither here nor there, nor between the two, nor between the two. Ese wando dukkhasa. This alone is at the end of suffering. That is referring to nirvana. In this sutta, the Buddha explained nirvana together with the practice, the way to attain, how to attain this nirvana also mentioned. So here nirvana means nevita nahura na ubhya mantrena ese wanto dukkhasa. The end of suffering is nirvana. Nirvana is the end of suffering. There is neither here nor there, nor between the two. That is the meaning. Not in the wall, not next wall. nowhere. Dete Dete Madam Vaisati means meditation practice. Mahasatipatthana, like Satipatthana practice is played. Through Satipatthana practice, one can attain Mega Phala. Through Mega Phala, he can attain Nirvana. So accordingly, the Buddha's brief to Bahia. The Buddha's briefing, Bahia understand and practice, following it, he attained Mega Phala. He became arahant. Such a teaching is not only to Bahia. Inside the Nikaya, Malukya Buddha also, the Buddha taught such a ways. That is very simple. For us also, we must follow this one. This is not the specific meditation, just Vipassana meditation, just Mahasatipatthana method, not other things. The same. You may think in meditation center, the meditation masters advise us to breathe in, breathe out, breathe in. Breathe in, breathe out also day-to-day, day-to-day. Okay? Seeing also, this is day-to-day, day-to-day. This method is the same. Whatever meditations may be, whatever object is may be, all type of objects lead into the same attainment, or together. Whatever practice may be, this follow. Then there are verses to explain it about Nirvana. Yatha apocha patavi tejo vayo nakatati. Like before we such a words is Ati Bhikkhave Tathāyatana Neva Pathavi Na Āpo. First Nirvana Sāyo, Pati Sāyo Da Sutta is like. Not so different. Yatha Abhocha Pathavi Tejo Vayo Nakhatati Natatha Sukha Jyotinti Adejo Na Pakasati. Where there exists not our water between earth, tejo, fire, while air, nagata does not exist. Okay? That is the meaning. Where there is no avo, neither water, no earth, no fire, no air. That is the meaning. There is no material quality at all. Where there is no material qualities at all. No, not matter. Not matter remained, not matter exist. This is Nirvana state. That is a Nirvana state. Because of material qualities remained in the almost entire war, apart from Aruba war, material qualities have remained. There exist material qualities apart from Aruba Brahma war. So, Yatha Abhocha Pathavi Tejo Vayo Nakatati. Where there is no grateful element, there Natatha Sukha Jodanti. The white is not bright, not color, Sukha, white, Na Jodanti. Adicho Na Pakasati. The sun never shine. The sun does not shine. That is the meaning, there is no light, one to see. There is no the great, four great element. Where there is no great four great element, there is no sun, no light. That is the meaning. No light. Natata chandima pati. There is no moonlight. There is no moonlight. If there is no sun, no moon, maybe dark, you may think. Tamotata navichati. There is not dark. No dark at all. You see, light and dark is dealing with the matter. In that state, there is not matter at all. Therefore, we cannot say light and dark. Light and dark is regarding to material qualities. They are also material qualities. Light is a visible object, dark also visible object. With your eye, you can see dark. Some people think only light is can be seen. Dark also can be seen. Dark also visible object. Why you see in the dark? Oh, so dark. You see in dark. You see dark. You see in Dhamma Sangani, what is a Rupayatana? What is a visible object? The Buddha explained in Dhamma Sangani Abhidhamma test. He has said, light also visible object, dark also visible object. Andhakara. Most people also think we can see something with the light. You see? Depending on I am visible object, I am visible object, we can, the eye consciousness arises. There is a light important, attention is important. Without the light, we cannot see. But dark, no light, no need in light. Dark also can be seen, visible object. Dark also, you see, andhakara. That is a visible object. A kind of material quality. We can see light also. That is also material quality. Therefore, in Nirvana state, there is no, where there is no four great elements, there is no white, no sun, bright, no moon, light, tamodat. But there is no dark. Because there's not material quality, one to see. The more also material quality, dark also material quality, light also material quality. Yadaja adana veti muni moni na brahmano atarupa arupacha sukha dukkha pamuchati. The Muni. Muni means with the knowledge. Who knows? Muni means with the knowledge. Who have great knowledge. Brahmana means who removed mental defilement. Brahma is one who removed mental defilement. This is so referring to Arahant. One who removed mental defilements with the knowledge. Monina means with the knowledge. Adana viti. He realized Dhamma himself. He realized Dhamma. Pachatam viritapo when you hit. You see, Dhamma can be experienced twice alone. Pachatam means individually. We know our Dhamma. What we attain, we know. What one know, what one attain, only that one realize his attainment, not the others. He realized himself, Adana Vedi, Pachatan, like Pachatan Vedi Dabo when you hear. Individually, one realized Dhamma. That is the meaning he attained Mecca and Phala. Atta Rupa Arupata, Sukha Dukha Pamuchati. Then, he free from Metta, free from my, free from sukha, pleasant, and dukkha, unpleasant. So, he free from metta, material quality, is my and mental state, pleasant things and unpleasant things, sukha, dukkha. Sukha, dukkha means regarding to vedana, especially vedana. When we attain nirvana, just this, anybody says nirvana, there is no more sukha dukkha. No more sukha dukkha. There will be no more material quality as mine. This is the final liberation. So this verse explain about nirvana. Not the different ones. First nirvana, Patisanyutta Suttas also mentioned this one. Okay, the same things. Yata abhoja patavi tejo vayo nagadadi. Natata sukha chotanti adi chona pakasati. Natata chandima bhati tamodata navichati. Sadaja adana veti muni moni na brahmano. Atharuba arubaja sukha dukha pamuchati. What do you say? He see, he free from all suffering, all dukkhas. He use rupa, arupa, sukha, dukkha. Free from. So this is according to Bhaiya Sutta. Now, five suttas. So many suttas will be explained according to the Buddha's teachings. Okay. Let me stop this lecture.